They were three different individuals. God set up the courses of Jacob and Moses as models for Jesus' course to save humankind. Satan, who does not meekly surrender even before God, would by no means readily surrender to Jesus. Therefore, God called upon Jacob and Moses and worked through them to show the course for bringing Satan into submission. Moses brought the Israelites out of Egypt, the satanic world, with miracles and signs, led them across the Red Sea, and had them wander through the wilderness before entering the promised land of Canaan. This foreshadowed the course on which Jesus would one day lead Christians. With miracles and signs, Jesus would bring Christians out of lives of sin and lead them safely across the troubled sea of evil. He would take them through a desert devoid of life-giving water before guiding them into the Garden of Eden of God's promise. Both courses were prolonged three times because of the Israelites' faithlessness. The first national course to restore Canaan based on Moses' 40 years in Pharaoh's palace, and the second national course based on his 40 years in the wilderness of Midian, all ended in failure due to the faithlessness of the Israelites. In the third national course, through the 40 years wandering in the wilderness, honoring the tabernacle until the Israelites returned to Kadesh Barnea, Moses was able to establish the foundation of faith. The Israelites were to establish the foundation of substance by honoring the tabernacle with faith and devotion and following Moses into Canaan. God instructed Moses to strike the rock with his staff that it might yield water and give drink to the people. However, when Moses heard the people complaining against him, he raged in uncontrolled anger and struck the rock twice. This created a condition for Satan's invasions, and thus Moses failed the dispensation to start based on the rock. As a consequence, he was not permitted to enter the promised land. God elevated Joshua to Moses' place. Joshua sent two men to spy out the city of Jericho. When they returned from Jericho, the two spies made a faithful report. The younger generation of Israelites raised in the wilderness all believed the spies' words, and this faith enabled them to start the third course. After the feast of Passover, they set out for Jericho. After marching around the city for 7 days, they raised a great shout, and the city walls tumbled down. Joshua conquered Canaan and defeated 31 kings altogether. Based on this victory, they laid the foundation of substance in the third national course. Jacob walked the symbolic course to bring Satan to submission, while Moses walked the image course. Their courses pioneered the way for Jesus to walk the actual course. In walking the worldwide course to subjugate Satan and to restore Canaan, Jesus followed the model demonstrated in the national course to restore Canaan, in which Moses was working to subjugate Satan. The first worldwide course to restore Canaan ended in failure due to the faithlessness of John the Baptist. Jesus himself now took on John's mission. When Jesus went through the 40-day fast and the three temptations in the wilderness, it was to separate Satan for the very purpose of restoring the foundation of faith and start the second worldwide course to restore Canaan. Due to the faithlessness of the Jewish people, however, Jesus had to bear the cross, and the second worldwide course thus ended in tragic failure. The resurrected Jesus spiritually resumed John the Baptist's mission. During the 40-day period of his resurrection, Jesus fulfilled the spiritual dispensation of 40 for the separation of Satan. By doing so, Jesus restored the foundation of faith for the spiritual course in the third worldwide course to restore Canaan. The resurrected Jesus gathered his scattered disciples and worked the dispensation to start by giving them the power to perform signs and miracles. The faithful believers in the position of Cain believed in and devotedly followed the resurrected Jesus. thereby fulfilling the indemnity condition to remove the fallen nature and restoring the spiritual foundation of substance. While Jesus has been restoring Canaan as a worldwide spiritual realm, the Christ at the Second Advent is to complete this third worldwide course as a substantial course and realize the actual kingdom of heaven on earth. Hence, returning Christ must be born on earth in the flesh. He will not die without fulfilling the providence of restoration, because God's providence after Adam and Jesus will be successful on the third attempt, that is, at the time of the Second Advent. Moreover, God's spiritual providence of restoration during the 2,000 years since Jesus has prepared a democratic society and legal environment which will protect Christ at the Second Advent. The returning Christ will conduct the dispensation to start based on the Word, and then complete the foundation for the Messiah, both spiritually and physically. Upon that foundation, he will cleanse all humanity of the original sin and restore them to be God's children born of his lineage. He will begin by laying both spiritually and physically the family foundation for the Messiah. He will then expand its scope to the clan, society, nation, world, and cosmos. When this foundation is secure, he will finally be able to build the kingdom of heaven.